Hi guys, welcome back to my vlog. For today's vlog, I am going to do a breakdown of The Mandalorian chapter 14 with the title The Tragedy. But before that, intro. Yes, I don't know why I'm dancing, I'm just so excited. Mandalorian keeps getting better and better. This chapter starts off with Din Djarin and Grogu inside the Razor Crest. They're headed to Tython, wherein Grogu might meet other Jedis there. Okay, now Grogu playing with his favorite knob, and Din Djarin is getting used to the fact that the kid has a name and it's Grogu. Okay, now Din Djarin is already practicing Grogu uses Force. Okay, at last they have reached Tython. They have reached the All-Seeing Stone with the use of his trusty jetpack. Okay, Din Djarin placed Grogu on top of the All-Seeing Stone. And then all of a sudden he saw this slave one pass by. When Mando looked back at Grogu to tell him we need to leave because we've got company, Grogu was already in this trance-like state wherein a force was already encircling him. Okay, now Din Djarin comes face to face with guess who? Drum roll please, it's Boba Fett. Now Boba has company with him and it is Fennec Shand. Yes. Just like me, I thought Fennec Shand died in the sands of Tatooine, but I guess Boba saved her. Now Boba just wants his armor back, and Mando is kind of firm that it should go with the Mandalorian Creed. Now, Boba said that the armor was given to him by his father Jango by Mando's forebearers. So Boba said, in exchange for the armor, he vows for Mando and Grogu's security because Grogu's bounty is now skyrocketing high. Now a bunch of stormtroopers showed up. Okay, now this is where this episode gets action-packed. Okay, guys, don't get me wrong. I love stormtroopers. Everybody loves stormtroopers, but dang, they can't aim. Okay, when I saw Boba Fett, I told myself, this episode, The Mandalorian has officially and irrevocably been awesome. Okay, The Mandalorian has put itself on the map of sheer awesomeness. This is especially when Boba Fett appeared in his full battle gear, and just before the stormtroopers left, Boba Fett gave them a parting gift and they were blown up. Okay, I was so devastated when the Razor Crest was blown to smithereens by a light cruiser. And guess who's riding that light cruiser? It is Moff Gideon. Now Mando realizes that it was after Grogu, so he tried to race them on the top of the mountain by foot. Yes, by foot, because he forgot his jetpack somewhere. Now Moff Gideon engaged dark troopers to get Grogu. Now Grogu is on top of this all-seeing stone and he was so exhausted. I guess it's from the force that he exerted before. And I was literally on the edge of my seat when the dark troopers came before Mando and took Grogu because he was sleeping. I guess he was so exhausted from all the force that he exerted. I felt so bad when Mando looked up and Grogu was looking back at him while he was being kidnapped. Now Boba Fett tried to chase them and saw that they were headed to a light cruiser. Now Boba Fett that realized then that the Empire is back. I felt sorry for Mando when he was checking on what was left of the Razor Crest and saw the knob that Grogu would love to play with, and underneath the rubble he saw the Beskar spear. Now Boba Fett vowed to help get Grogu back, who right now is donor material. Now Din Djarin, Boba Fett, and Fennec Shand goes to Nevarro City. Din Djarin talks to Cara Dune, who at the moment is the Marshal of the New Republic. Din Djarin explains that he needs to find this prisoner named Miggs Mayfeld. Okay, now Cara Dune says Miggs Mayfeld is serving a 50-year sentence imprisonment, okay? Now Cara Dune asks, why do you need Miggs Mayfeld for? Din Djarin said, I need Miggs Mayfeld for because he needs to help me locate the light cruiser that Moff Gideon is riding. Okay, now Cara Dune said, like, I know we're friends, but I am the Marshal of the New Republic and I've got rules to follow. Now, Din Djarin just said, they got the kid. Now, meanwhile, inside the light cruiser, Grogu has got this some kind of tantrum because he is showing his force to the poor stormtroopers. Okay, there was even this time he even force choked a stormtrooper, I guess out of sheer anger and frustration. Now, Gideon watches his interest as the child hurls two stormtroopers against the wall before he collapses in exhaustion. Moff Gideon was so pleased with what he saw and showed to the very exhausted Grogu his darksaber before ordering a stormtrooper to stun Grogu to sleep and put handcuffs on him. Now Moff Gideon said, send an encrypted message to Dr. Pershing stating that they've got the child. So that's it. Overall, this episode is a 10 out of 10 for me. I really felt sad that Mando and Grogu got separated, but hey, we all do know that this is going to happen, and it happened in this episode. Okay, so that's it for my breakdown on episode 6, entitled The Tragedy of the Mandalorian. I hope you enjoyed my vlog as much as I did. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. And while you're at it, please hit that notification bell for more updates. See you soon. See you on my next vlog. Gotta go, gotta hike, gotta do something with my life. Peace out.